Hey guys, Shambi here, and today we're gonna talk about a default 4-star summoning event. This is the third time, if I remember correctly, that Comptos have done this, and this event is really, really amazing because you get exactly what you want. So, very simple, you play every day, you do stuff, you get points. 500 points per day, and you can summon once a day. How long is that? Is that, I would say, 40 plus days, and there are like around 40 nat 4 in the game. A lot of people think that you can't, but you definitely will get the nat 4 that you want, no matter how unlucky you are, if you play every single day and get 500 points. If we are talking about PvE progression only, I think the best unit to pick is definitely Lucian. Because you can use this guy immediately in Giant Speed 10 and it's gonna cut down your time to really, really fast. My endgame account used Lucian in all farming dungeon. Why is he so good? He provides a tank leader for dungeon 33%. His amputation magic can destroy the trash wave, the golems, without a need for attack buff if you hit the required stats. My Lucian is actually the bare minimum Lucian you need to clear out the trash wave without the need for attack buff. Many people will tell you that you're trying to get Galleon for dungeon farming. In my opinion, you don't need this guy for dungeon farming. He has very bad AI. Half the time, he doesn't use time to loot. He will go for like pirate strike for no absolute reason. It's insane. He's so stupid. Instead of using Galleon for defense break, I use Lauren and Fran together as a combination. So you have attack buff all the time, you have armor break all the time. Lauren, armor break is from a passive skill, so there's no chance for her to derp and not defense break the boss. You need Galleon to have max skill to work, and if you are pulling your first Galleon, your first pirate ever, you won't be able to use him immediately. You also saw Sabrina in the banner. This girl is an absolute beauty. Most of you, not all of you, will already have the Light Chakram Dancer. This girl from Hope Heroes. So if you pull this girl, you can use her with the future Talia that you pull, or your future Shiner, or you can use her immediately with your Deva. So I would say Sabrina is the best to choose if you don't own any twin just yet. If you already have Sabrina, Talia is a very good choice. She can do a huge amount of damage on both Giants, Dragons, and Necrobeaten. They are very good for Reef Beast farming as well. Let's go through the element and see what are the other good options if you already have them. In the Wind department, I would say my top pick will be Triana. Because she's good in guild battle, offense and defense. She's good in RTA. She's even good in arena defense with Vanessa. And you can fuse Harmonia to skill her up. In guild battle, I really love using her against Odin with a water tank. So she will save your water tank immediately because Odin doesn't do mountain hit. So he will do one big hit and then Triana will save that unit immediately. It's really, really good. And she also gives you immunity and cleansing to deal with the Bastet debuff. If you want a dedicated damage dealer for guild battle, Skogul is awesome. You can stack a lot of HP on him and that's it. This guy only needs HP to do damage and he can do a lot of damage ignoring defense and element. He can tank Prona as well, make him a perfect choice for offense team. And you see him in defense as well, together with Jahn and Chandra and Prona, very annoying to deal with. In Siege, very popular choice for guild siege defense in Nat 4 tower. So Skogul, solid unit. An underrated RTA pick would be Shimite. I think he's amazing. He provides 24% speed lead. Very, very good. He can remove all beneficial effects. Not one, but all. And then reduce that unit attack bar. If he's fast enough, he can shut down Cleave. He can shut down Fran. He can open a hole for Sierra to bomb, for Ganny to reset, for Perna to do damage. A very, very solid unit for RTA. And if you use him to cleave, you can check out some other YouTube video to show you that he is used in top tier guardian level cleave for RTA. In the water department, if you want to cleave, you definitely go for Galleon, but make sure you have skill up for him, because if you don't have skill up and you're trying to run like a Galleon, Zyros, whatever, right? And then you miss the defense break, nobody's gonna kill anything. So prepare skill up for Galleon. He's definitely a good choice for PvP cleave. For PvE, by that I mean farming in Dragons, Giants, I think Lauren is a much, much better defense break option. More consistent. I love consistency. This boy needs no introduction. A crazy unit for both Guild Battle and RTA. One of the best water damage deal in the game right now. He makes Chao look like trash.
To go with this, but at the same time, Giana does have skill 3 up, so he needs to freeze that giant Giana.
There's the freeze and the additional turn, cleansing that bomb.
Very huge proc, very huge freeze there. At the same time, Thompson is not going to be able to stun unless he violent procs.
Gets that turn 2 sleep onto Diana as well. Does not get stunned up due to the immunity. Trying to finish up that Giana, and he does so.
That Giana not getting a shot at life here. Not getting a shot to proc. And Thompson's Antares has not proc'd very much at all this game.
No, not at all by any means. It's not the Antares we've seen before.
Yeah, and again, that Diana did not proc her either. So nothing's proc'ing on Thompson's side this match.
I mean, Diana could potentially take the match.
We've seen it before.
In a 22% world.
But Boss playing this very well, controlling this
definitely
very well
is.
With the Lauren, the Aegir, the Alucia. I mean, Boss has done a great job showing control this match, and it's going to be 1-1.
Definitely going to be 1-1 here. Looking to get that kill right here.
This guy also provides a HP leader for Guild Battle. He's often seen in Guild Siege defense with Skogo and Triana. Two top win pick that I recommend, and this guy is the third pick for Guild Battle. Very, very good in RTA. He needs no introduction. Another speed lead in the water department. This guy is amazing. I owe my DaisyB account success in TOA to this guy. I didn't need to fuse a Jahn, and this guy without skill up can handle all the crowd control I need with Math. Okay? Math allow him to gain back his Hellstorm much faster. He can control the entire wave with attack power reduction, freezing, and slow debuff. Speed lead make him so much better in early game arena because nobody has will runes or immunity. So this guy on a Swift set can destroy a lot of people in RTA even, like in noob RTA. And with the speed lead, he helps me to farm arena better with Lucian. So very solid unit. He's one of the oldest netfall in the game and still stands strong as one of the best water netfall in my opinion. If you don't have Sabrina, you get Sabrina. If you have Sabrina, you may want to get Talia. These two make dungeon farming a joke. They're so good. If we're not talking about PvE anymore, then Izaria is a very solid option for RTA. This girl controls Fire Lich really, really well with constant sleep, provides speed lead for you to outspeed the enemy, and her control on Lich, Verdahl, very, very good. I love using this girl when there's no Diana in the field. In the fire department, if we go back 2 years ago, 3 years ago, I would say you pick up your boy Verd and your girl Chloe. But now in 2019, they're not that crazy anymore. You can farm for this guy. And there's only one unit I really like, which is this guy. And that is a very biased opinion, okay? Until this day, there are still people amazed at this guy's damage output. He's amazing. He does so much damage with so little.
How could we have forgot Rina? How much is he gonna do? Bop. Stupid!
I love him, but he's definitely not a top pick. Ah, it hurts me to say that. He's really amazing. This girl, before the nerf, she was like the hottest thing ever. If you have Sabrina, people will have a hard time deciding between Shyna and Talia. But now, not really. She used to be the key defense breaker for most dungeon team. You can use Lauren for that purpose and pick up Talia. If you want more damage, you pick up another Talia. She lost her place in PvP because she lost the speed lead in arena. Also took away the attack power reduction, which was insane. But for DaisyB account, I'm actually picking one unit from the fire department, and that's gonna be your boy Garo. I have Lucian, have Sabrina, have Aja, and I don't really think I need to do Guild Battle seriously anytime soon, but I need this guy to clear a Chroma in TOA Heart in peace. So I'm gonna pick up myself a Garo to make sure that I clear TOA Heart every month. But if you have no problem with TOA Heart, you have no problem with But if you have no problem with TOA Heart like me, the Chroma stage, you definitely can pick up the top picks that I mentioned in the other elements because I love using them so much. I use them until today. I've been playing with so many units and those were my favorite. But for DaisyB, I have to go for Garo, because having a unit that can deal with that one particular hardest stage in the game is very convenient in my opinion. Okay, let's do one RTA for the memes, alright? I bet you, we're gonna get Genny Hathor, some crazy Nat 5 showcase, because that's what happened in Dao and Challenger 3 even. Like, people just start playing today and they just destroy me. My plan for RTA is very simple. I secure my Lauren and I lost my Lauren and my Vert. But it's okay, I secure my Tyrone, because in the lower rank, people don't usually have Wirun, so a Swift Tyrone is very good. Okay, he has... So, he let me have the speed lead and the Bastet. My Bastet right now is 161 bonus speed. Not too shabby, I think it's decent enough for this rank, but we shall see the enemy. He's using the top tier Nat 4 that I mentioned, but as I said, in the lower rank, there's no Wirunes. Most of them. So we're gonna start freezing, and we're gonna reset the skill of Aja in case he violent proc. Likely he's on violent. We're gonna try to put attack break here. We're gonna put attack break here. We don't need to put up immunity yet because nothing's moving. And then we're gonna put armor break for Tyrone to reduce attack bar one more time. This is a Tyrone showcase to show you why he's a very, very good unit. So we reset Tyrone for more freeze. And the She-Hulk may violent proc, so I'm gonna be careful here and put up this. You're gonna do more damage to Aja, finish him out. Nope, not yet, but we reduce attack bar once again. So that's really, really strong. The fact that I'm reducing attack bar every single turn and not just freezing. And now the She-Hulk once again shut down. He can't do anything. This is amazing. The Tyrone showcase that you have been waiting for. Oh, Lauren violent prop, but he does have glancing. Okay, the glancing didn't really work out too well. Can I try to kill Vert? Beautiful, we're gonna reset the She-Hulk. My Genny's on some leftover Swift rune, so I'm not even proccing violent, and we are good to go. So your boy just destroyed a fighter one player. This is my Genny right now. Look at this. It's speed, HP, and attack. Look at how amazing my Genny is. Max skill, by the way. It's gonna take a while before I 6-star my Genny. Okay, we lost our Genny. Let's take a look at my accuracy here. It is 71 accuracy. Not the worst. Diana. Okay. He's gonna go. I think he's autoing. Oh, this guy's autoing. That's not fun anymore. He is definitely autoing. But I don't mind free wins. Even though he's autoing, there's a good chance I may lose if I'm not careful, because they're all strong Nat 5, right?
A few moments later.
I'm getting auto, but it's all good. Alright. There was nothing else he can do anyway. So, young Daisy B is in Fighter 1. Alright. That's it for me today, guys. Another Daisy B episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any question, let me know down in the comment section below. I'll try my best to answer your comments. And I'll see you guys next time. Subscribe. Yeah, subscribe. Before I forget. Bye.